It's meant the world to me, and I hope I gave you everything I had.
What was your vantage point of that fumble when Thomas hits Jefferson and then Brady comes in?
Shoot, my vantage point was I missed the tackle, so I was like, damn. So I turned to look, and I saw him try to go over Thomas, and Thomas rose up. Ball came out, Brady picked it up. I was like, ball game blouses.
Troy, when you think back to that 2016 defense, how nice is it for, you know, to be on this defense and for it to come down to you guys getting a couple stops there at the end?
Man, it's been amazing. It's been super great to see how the defense has grown and matured over the past 4 years since I've been here. It's awesome to see how the young guys have stepped up, beat them tremendously for this defense. It just means a lot to the senior class because we have been through a lot. We played on one of the worst defenses in the nation, and now we're on one of the best defenses in the nation. So it just shows how resilient these guys are and how much they work in the offseason and put in the time to learn Coach Avila's playbook. And, I mean, just kudos to those guys for doing what they needed to do, man. I love all those guys and do anything for them.
What was the emotion like out there to be able to do this one more time?
It meant the world to me, man, especially to win the Civil War. It means the world. I mean, it don't matter what the record is for the season, as long as you walk off the field with the win in the Civil War, man, the season feels great. Like, we beat Washington and we beat Oregon State this year. So, I mean, I'm super happy and I'm super stoked. And we beat Stanford. So, I mean, it's like, damn, like, hit all three of them. So, I'm just super proud of the guys and happy the way they bounced back and where they battled all year. And, stay strong and never let adversity get us down. And nobody ever pointed the finger at each other, and everybody always had each other's back. And I think it shows when our back's against the wall, everybody's willing to fight for each other. So, I mean, I love these guys with all my heart.
When did it kind of click for you that this was it, your last game, or did it just feel like a regular game for you?
Man, it was clicking when that was my last game after the Arizona State game. I was like, man, I got one more regular season game. Really, real talk. After the Arizona game, I was like, man, I got one more home game. Like, no matter how you look at it, you only got one more now. And that was the last one. I mean, no matter what I want to do, no matter how bad I want to go back, no matter how mad if I want another year, it's not going to happen. And that was it. And that was my send-off for Otton. And I wouldn't take it no other way. And I'm just happy we got the dub.
How did that last shout feel?
Man, it felt amazing, man. I just felt the energy from the crowd. My teammates was bumming back. And it just felt like the world was on, just watching me, and it was just fun to have fun with the teammates and really go out with the band.
The ref was kind of acting as your holdback guy there at the end.
Man, they was trying to keep me, man, but you know you can't hold me back on my last shout, man. I don't give a damn. Lucky I didn't go to the middle of the O. Lucky we wasn't up by a couple more touchdowns. I would have been real disrespectful out there. But no, I mean, I'm just super grateful for the opportunities that the Austin's given me and all the fans and my teammates and my coaches that I've had over the past 4 years. It just meant the world to me.
How long do you think about this win before you think about Utah? Or do you let this enjoy
it? Hey, whoever we play, whether it's Utah or USC, we got to just get this win. Celebrate it tonight, but come tomorrow, whoever we got is who we got, and we're looking forward to the challenges that both teams bring.
Just enough time to really play your best, 6 days to prepare for a team, and do you feel that you're going to be primed to play your best?
I mean, yeah, we've already had a Friday game this year, so I think we're already ready, and we know how to use that schedule. And I think Coach Richball and Coach and the rest of the staff have done a great job of setting up a schedule. And I think we'll be fine. It's not a super short week. We're not playing on Thursday. We're playing on a Friday. So we still get all the same amount of practices. We just don't get that off day. But who really needs an off day when you beat Oregon State?
So I realize it was Bailey on the line and it changed day. But run fits wise, how do you feel like you guys did? Like the big package of Sioni out there. Not usually what necessarily you guys do, but you didn't seem to be effective early on. How do you feel like you guys did against the
line? Everybody was out there doing their job tonight. Everybody played with inside the scheme. And I think we executed Coach Avalos' defense to a T, except for some miscues that we had. But I mean, everybody's human, so everybody makes mistakes. But I mean, we're super proud of the way we play today, because when you walk through with the dub, I mean, we did enough to get to stop them from scoring more points than you. So I mean, anytime you get that, it's a big time thing, because winning the Pac-12 is hard, and we've seen that week in and week out. So I mean, I'm super proud of the guys and where they stepped up. Everybody came out. Like you said, Sione came in and stepped up. Brandon Dolas came in and played a key role. I mean, a lot of guys that were asked to come in and play and key parts of the game, and they did that, and they did the job very well.